Hi, my name is Hairuna Rasa binti Azlan. My meter number is 2112854 and I'm from section 8.
Hi, my name is Masali Izzati binti Kamaruddin. My metric number is 2113632 and I'm from section 8.
Hi, my name is Fatima Umaira binti Zadisha. My metric number is 2114480 and I'm from section 8.
Assalamualaikum. My name is Ahana Amani binti Mama Azam. My metric number is 2111644. I'm from section 9.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nur Irina Safia binti Mike Kamarizai. My metric number is 2114264 and I'm from section 9.
First of all, we will know what is market. The concept of a market is any structure that allows buyers and sellers to exchange any type of goods, services, and information. The exchange of goods and services with or without a money is also considered as a transaction. Market participants consist of all the buyers and sellers. This concept given rise to several theories and models in economics concerning the basic market forces of supply and demand.
My name is Ahna Amani, so now I will continue with the demand. So the definition of demand is consumer's desire and ability to purchase a good or service. The law of demand is illustrated by demand curve, which is downward sloping. It is an inverse relationship between price and quantity. So which, when the price goes up, the demand goes down, and vice versa, which is when the price goes down, the demand goes up. For example, when the price of grape goes down, the quantity demanded for grape will increase, and vice versa. So next, we will see the demand schedule. So in the y-axis, we will see the price, and in the x-axis, we will see the quantity. So we can see that as the price goes up, demand goes down. Three reasons why demand is downward sloping is because of substitution effect, income effect, and law of diminishing marginal utility. And lastly, we'll see the five determinants of demand, which will shift the demand curve to the right or to the left. So the five determinants of demand are change in taste or preferences, change in number of buyers, change in income, change in price of related goods, and lastly, change in consumer expectations. That's all from me. Thank you.
Next, we'll be talking about supply. Definition of supply is the willingness and ability of producers to create goods and services to take them to market. It is illustrated by supply curve upward sloping. The positive relationship between price and quantity, which is when the price goes up and the supply also increase, while when the price goes down, the supply will also decrease. For example, when the price of hand sanitizer goes up, the quantity supplies for hand sanitizer will increase and vice versa. There's something called law of supply. The producers will produce and sell more of their product at a high price than at a low price. There's direct relationship between price and quantity supply. Given a product cost, a higher price indicates larger profit, and hence a stronger incentive to provide more. As you can see, this is an example of market supply schedule. As the price goes up, the quantity supplied per month also goes up. Next, it's about the determinant of supply. Determinant of supply is the factors that may cause changes in or affect the supply of a product in the marketplace. And some of the determinants are the change in price of related goods, change in resource prices, change in technologies, change in producer expectations, change in number of sellers, and last, change in tax and subsidies.
Next, I will be explaining about market equilibrium. So the definition of market equilibrium is a market state where the supply in the market is equal to the demand in the market. If a market is at equilibrium, the price will not change unless unless an external factor changes the supply or demand, which results in a disruption of the equilibrium. In market equilibrium, we have five topics outlined, which is surplus, shortage, equilibrium price and quantity, rationing function of prices, and also changes in supply, demand and equilibrium. So surplus is the amount of a resource that exceeds the amount that is actively utilized. It can be used in the context of profits, goods, tax, income and capital. So a surplus results from a disconnect between supply and demand for a product, or whether some people are willing to pay more for a product than other consumers. Typically, a surplus causes a market disequilibrium in the supply and demand of the product. Next, shortages is a condition where the quantity demanded is greater than the quantity supplied at the market price. The causes of shortage is increase in demand, which is outward shift in the demand curve. Second is decrease in supply, which is inward shift in the supply curve. Last is government intervention. Next is equilibrium price and quantity. Equilibrium price is the price of a good or service when the supply of it is equal to demand for it in the market. While equilibrium quantity is when there is no shortage or surplus of a product in the market. Next is rationing function of prices. Rationing function of price features raising the price higher so that less of the consumable will be purchased and used by the consumer, and more will be conserved or rationed. So the effect of rationing function of price is to discourage demand, conserve resources, and also spread out their use over time. So this is a diagrammatic explanation. A market starts with a stable equilibrium where demand equals supply. Then a supply shock reduces supply at each and every price. This creates an excess of demand at the existing price. So when the price is now forced up to a new price, which is P1, where the market clears, at the new price, demand and supply are brought into equilibrium through a contraction of demand, which is the rationing effect, and an extension of supply, which is the incentive effect. Next, in the long run, the higher price ends up signals either for existing firms to introduce better production methods or by new firms entering the market. This causes the supply curve to shift to the right. Eventually, price may return to its existing level. Next is changes in supply, demand and equilibrium. Changes in market equilibrium. The demand curve shifts when any of the non-price dominant of demand changes, and supply curve will also shift when any of the non-price dominant of supply changes. These changes depicted by the right or leftward shift in the demand and supply curve, which will lead to changes in the equilibrium price and the equilibrium quantity. Next is change in demand, which is a change in one or more of the non-price dominance of demand causes a change in demand. Change in demand can be seen by the shifting of the demand curve to the left or right. So, as we can see based on the diagram, the increase in demand from D1 to D2 in A increases both equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. Next, the decrease in demand from D3 to D4 in B decreases both equilibrium price and also equilibrium quantity. Next is changes in supply. So, change in supply is a change in one or more of the non-price dominance of supply causes a change in supply. Change in supply can be seen through the shifting of supply curve to the left or right. As you can see in the diagram, the increase in supply from S1 to S2 in C increases equilibrium price and increases equilibrium quantity. Next, the decline in supply from S3 to S4 in D increases equilibrium price and also decreases equilibrium quantity. So, this is a table of effects of changes in both supply and demand. So, when change in supply increase, change in demand will be decreased, and the effect on equilibrium price also will be decreased. So, the effect on equilibrium price will be decreased.
Next, we'll move on to the next one, which is the government set prices. So, there are two government set prices, which are price ceiling and price block. Firstly, the price ceiling. Price ceiling is defined as the maximum legal price a seller may charge for a product or a service. So referring to the graph, the price ceiling is set below the equilibrium price of the product. And why? It has its own purpose. It is to enable consumers to obtain substantial goods or services that they could not afford at the equilibrium price. So
usually pricing is set on items that is considered as basic necessities, and it is to make sure that all consumers are able to obtain it at an affordable price at all times. So, for example of pricing is the price of COVID-19 self-test kit. The price of COVID-19 self-test kit has been set a price ceiling by the government last October. Under the tagline of safely reopening the economic sector, the government realized the importance for the public to regularly self-test themselves to curb the spread of the virus and pandemic. To make it accessible for everyone, the government set a price ceiling of RM19.90 back in October 2021, lower than the market price of which was back in October 2021. As of December 2021, the COVID-19 self-test kit can be purchased at a much cheaper price as low as RM6.90, as the government gazetted the product as a control goods. So this is a clear example of pricing, which helps to lower down the price that the consumers have to pay to obtain a good, which is the COVID-19 self-test kit. Next one is the price floor. Price floor is defined as the minimum legal price a seller may charge for a product or service. So, referring to the graph, the price floor is set above the equivalent price, which is opposite of the price ceiling. While price ceiling is to help the consumers, price floor is to help the producers, to help the sellers. Why is it that so? It is to help suppliers or producers when society feels the market system is not providing a sufficient income for certain group or resource suppliers and producers. This is also to make sure that the suppliers or producers are back up with something in case of they are experiencing losses. For example, of price floor in Malaysia is the minimum wage that the government has set. The minimum wage of Malaysia currently is RM1,200, whereby all workers are entitled to at least RM1,200 for their monthly wage. This is to make sure that they obtain sufficient amount of income to sustain their cost of living in the country. So next, I'll pass over to the next presenter.
Now I will explain the impact of COVID-19 on our economy nowadays. Surely you are all wondering how COVID-19 affects the interaction of demand and supply in the Malaysian market. This time, I will bring you to the face mask market. In 2019, COVID-19 virus has spread worldwide. It has affected everyone. When this virus appeared, the government has set standard operating procedure, or we will call it as SOP, that must be adhered to all citizens. One of the SOP is to wear a face mask. This will increase the public demand for face masks. This has led to the movement of the market demand curve due to the increase in the demand for face masks from each individual. Based on the economic theory described earlier, this is known as the determinant of demand, not on the price of the goods. Next, the concept of supply will respond to the demands of society. When the demand for face masks is high, manufacturers will start producing the face masks. This will increase the supply of the face masks in the market. The equilibrium in the market can be controlled and always maintained.
In conclusion, as Malaysia is adapting the mixed economy system whereby we rely on the free market system and also government's intervention in the market, the concept of supply and demand is no stranger for consumers and sellers of the country. As price of a good or service rises, the quantity demanded of the product will fall and vice versa, while the quantity supplied will increase along with the price hike and vice versa. Everyone who is involved in the market truly wants to obtain profit and avoid losses. Hence, it is necessary for government to intervene in the free market whenever needed to obtain a satisfiable equilibrium of the market. As long as proactive actions are taken, the economy can obtain a stable equilibrium to ensure maximum satisfaction for everyone.